Hello, and welcome to part two of my entire Louis Vuitton collection. Last Saturday, I posted the video of all of my Louis Vuitton handbags. Today, I'll be showing you everything else. All the, I'm gonna call them small goods because there's not just one word for them. I have, let me look around here, scarves, agendas, sort of miscellaneous pieces, wallets, pouches, bag charms, luggage tags, some consumables, several limited edition pieces. So if that sounds interesting to you, stay tuned. Hi YouTube, Autumn Beckman here. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. My channel is all about luxury living on a budget, from high-end luxury handbags and small goods, like we're talking about today, to the everyday luxuries of life, which encompasses so many things. If that sounds interesting to you, please make sure you subscribe, click the bell notification icon to be notified when I post new videos, and be sure to like the videos that you enjoy. One of the perks of subscribing is that on your YouTube homepage, you will see my community posts, and that is where I share information about sales and discount codes, so you can get bargains on some of the things we all love. If you are new to this channel, welcome. This is a great place to start. In the month of January, I do all my collection videos on Saturdays. So in the description box below, I'll post the handbags video from last week, so you can check that out. I'll also be posting other videos related to some of the things that I talk about. So if you see any pieces that you want to know more about, check down below and I might have a video on it. In my handbag video, I talked about prices, what each bag cost retail, if I had that information, and what I paid for it. I'm not going to do that in this video just because there are so many pieces. The handbag video, I talked about 15 pieces and it was about 40 minutes long. So I'm gonna try to talk less this time and just show you what I have. And if there's something that I feel you should know, because I do like to impart my knowledge and the things that I've learned about luxury pieces, then I'll let you know. But I'm going to try to keep it short, or shorter. I just counted and I have 57 pieces to show you today. So let's get started. I will say very quickly before we get started that there is a debate among some people in the luxury community about whether you should spend money on small goods at all, or if you should just get handbags, because those are like the big thing to get, right? I felt that way in the beginning, where I wanted to save my money for handbags. I thought if I spent money on SLGs, small leather goods, like wallets and things, they'd be hidden inside the bag and you'd never see them. However, once I started buying those, I learned that I actually use these small leather goods a lot more than I use the handbags. I'm constantly pulling them out, I'm getting stuff out of them, I'm pulling out wallets to pay. I now think that SLGs are totally worth it. And speaking of that, one of the videos I have coming up later this month, maybe in the beginning of February, is my 2021 wish list. And I've acquired a lot of pieces on my previous wish lists. I would love to know, especially from the people who have been watching my channel for a while, what would you put on my wish list? Let me know in the comment section below. I'm curious what pieces you think I need. And also, as you're watching this, think about small goods that you have or want and tell me what is your favorite Louis Vuitton small good and why. I look forward to reading those comments. Okay, let's get started. These are in no particular order, and hopefully I won't forget to film anything this time. All right, I'm gonna start with two consumable items. I don't know, some people may not think these count, but I totally do, and I'll tell you why. First, I have a perfume sample. This is the Louis Vuitton Cactus Garden. I'm gonna put some on right now. Those of you who watched my Vlogmas in December saw me get this from Becca, my sales associate at the Houston Galleria. If you're looking for any brand new items from Louis Vuitton, her information is in the description box below. She's great at helping you find stuff, so feel free to text her. She gave me the sample of Cactus Garden with a purchase that I made, and I'm usually not a perfume person, but I love this so much, I am planning to buy a bottle later this month from her. So that's why I included the sample, because Cactus Garden is a part of my collection now. She also gave me this. It's a little bottle of the Rose du Vent. Is that how to say it? People were telling me how to pronounce it, and I think it's Rose du Vent. Lovely, lovely scent as well. It smells like roses. A couple more sort of random items that I have. This. I include this in my wish list because it is a Louis Vuitton item and not everyone would include it, but it's a little microfiber cloth for cleaning sunglasses. It probably came with a pair of sunglasses. I don't have a pair of Louis Vuitton sunglasses. I am not a fan of the thought of spending a lot of money on sunglasses because I drop them off my head, they get scratched, they get broken, they get lost. So I'm not willing to buy sunglasses. They cost hundreds or even over $1,000. But I got this off eBay a few years ago. It came with something else, so I include that. And then I also have these three little pins. You can see it's a wearable pin there. These are from the Volet, I don't know how to say that. It says it on the top there. The exhibition in New York City from 2018. I'm looking down at the next item I was going to show you, which is the exhibition catalog from that show. Some of these pieces were gifted to me by other YouTubers who lived in New York and were able to get those for me. These pins were free at the show. They handed them out when you left the exhibition. I think the catalog would have been free too. I think actually the truck was given to me by Doc Luxury, who did not live in New York. And then I think I bought the other three pieces on eBay. But that's some random stuff you don't see every day. And then since I showed you that catalog, let me show you my books. I just purchased this one this past Christmas. This is the Louis Vuitton Spirit of Travel. And I was taking some Instagram photos today. I'm trying to get back into Instagram. And this looks really good with some items because it has that print on it. Nice prop. I'm also looking forward to actually looking through it. And then I'm not going to move all this stuff, but I have two books here. The top one is City Bags, A Natural History. If you want to learn more about Louis Vuitton handbags, the history of the handbags, and this is specific to handbags, different iterations of bags, how they've evolved, families of bags, construction of bags, different pieces that make the bags, how they do the screen printing, all kinds of things, like almost anything you'd want to know about Louis Vuitton bags. That is your book. That is the best reference book. It's fabulous. And then the one underneath that is called The Birth of Modern Luxury. It's not one that I'm really into. I picked that one up at Marshall's. It was a decent price, so I got it. And I like that it says Louis Vuitton. It looks nice in my background. It was wrapped in cellophane, so I couldn't flip through it before I bought it. I'm not really impressed with the contents of it. That City Bags book, favorite. The last Louis Vuitton book I have is this one. It is Louis Vuitton Art, Fashion, and Architecture. And this is the cover. It's in this acrylic sleeve thing to help keep it protected. I got this because it tells all about the different artist collaborations that Louis Vuitton has done, which I find really interesting and some of it fascinating. It has photo examples and it has some text that describes the collaborations. And then the covers, there are three different covers. Oh, I guess I have that upside down. So this is one. There's one with the Murakami LV. And then there's a third one that I forget what it is, and it was my favorite one. But when you order this, if you were to order it online, for example, you can't pick which cover you get. You just get whatever you get. So it's better if you want a specific cover to try to find that in the store so you can at least look at it first. Okay, I'm gonna take this back now. That is my second favorite book next to the City Bags book. They're both fabulous reference books if you want to learn more about Louis Vuitton. All right, next, my stack of Louis Vuitton agendas, some of my favorite and most used Louis Vuitton items. My desk agenda, by far my favorite and most used piece, at least as far as agendas, and probably my most used of all of my Louis Vuitton items. I'm using it right now for notes for this video. Guess I'll go big to small. My agenda GM, and most of my agendas are in Damier Ben. It's my favorite print. My agenda MM, which is unfortunately my least used agenda. I'm actually not using it at all. Haven't for a while, but not willing to get rid of it. I want to keep the collection because someday I may use it again. And my agenda PM, which I talked about in Vlogmas. I purchased the Louis Vuitton inserts for that. And I did the daily inserts where it has, let me show you a blank page. It has one page per day. And I'm using that to do to-do lists because I always have long to-do lists every day. And that's working out perfectly so far. The pen loop is tiny on here, so I will link this pen. I try to do that every time I mention this agenda. And this was gifted to me by Winnie B. LV. So thank you again, Winnie. I love it. Along with my agendas, I have the Expert Pen Case. This is in Damier Graphite, the dark grays with silver hardware. How this works is you unzip it, you open those flaps, and there are four little loops there for pens. So I keep some of my fountain pens in there and a gold pen that I use for accents in my journals. Okay, let's do scarves next. I have this one big shawl. This is the monogram shawl. Beige or white or whatever they call it. It's not white. It's here, I'll hold it against me. You can see it better so it doesn't blow everything out. It's like a light cream color. It's lightweight. It's warm. It's comfortable. It's cashmere and wool. Is that right? No, it's silk and wool. Yeah, silk and wool. However, it also snags easily, like pulls easily, especially on jewelry, so you have to be careful with it. And the fabric also pills easily. Be aware of that before you spend that much money on one of these. I purchased this pre-loved, so I didn't pay full price for it. All right, my bandeaus. This one is my least favorite. This is the flower ink bandeau in white, light pink, and gray. And then on the other side, in kind of a dusty rose, it has the monogram print. This is my least favorite because I don't wear these colors very often. But also, you'll notice when you compare these to the other bandeaus I hold up, this is pretty wrinkled. All the other ones that I have, they don't wrinkle like this. If you tie them on something and then hang them, the wrinkles just come out. That hasn't happened with this one. Notice, too, the shape of this one. It's really long and skinny, and it has these diagonally cut corners. That's different from all the other bandeaus that I have from Louis Vuitton. So there are three different size bandeaus from them that I have found, besides really big ones. There's that one, there's this size, this is the regular size, and this has the squared off corners. This is the confidential bandeau in browns. And then the other size looks the same, and you wouldn't know it's any different unless you compare the two or you look at dimensions. So this also has the squared off end. This is the Jungle 16 in the blues and purples. When you compare the two sizes, you can see that the Jungle 16 is quite a bit larger. It's wider and it's also a couple inches longer. This one has the monogram print in lavender on the other side, and I think this is just gorgeous, and it's a bandeau that's very difficult to find. I have two more bandeaus to show you. One is this leopard bandeau. This is a Stephen Sprouse print, and it has the graffiti Louis Vuitton there in fuchsia. And then my newest bandeau, I purchased this a few months ago. I'm trying to find the side where it says Louis Vuitton. It's this one. It's the Buildings bandeau, and it's the Chrysler Building in New York City. And then on the back it has the black and gray monogram. This one I paid more for because it has these little metal pieces attached to it. I will tell you a couple things, a couple quick recommendations about buying Vuitton bandeaus. First of all, Hermes is better and they're cheaper. So if you don't care about Louis Vuitton specifically, I would check Hermes first. Theirs are also smaller, they're twillies. Generally speaking, the quality is better. The quality of the Vuitton bandeaus is not consistent, in my opinion. Some are really nice, like the ones I have are what I consider really nice. Others, I don't think they're printed very well. Some of the fabrics aren't that nice. The Vuitton bandeaus tend to go for about $200, $180 or $200, I don't know what the current price is, but right around $200. Hermes, I think they're around $165, some might be a little more. This one, because of the metal pieces, was like $300. Stupid to charge that much more for these silly little things. It was one that I really wanted, so I was willing to pay the extra for it. Also, if you see a bandeau that you know you really want, like on the Louis Vuitton website or in the Louis Vuitton store, buy it because they can sell out pretty quickly. On the pre-loved market, unless there's a bandeau that I just cannot get new anymore because it's sold out and they're not making it anymore, and it's one that I am absolutely in love with and I have to have it, I wouldn't pay more than retail for these. I mean, it depends. You can make your own decisions about what you want to spend on things, but that would be my recommendation. All right, trying to decide what to do next. I have bag charms and luggage tags, and I have a bunch of pouches and wallets and things. I think I'll do the pouches and wallets and then save the bag charms for last because I think they're the most fun. Start with my smallest pouches, the Louis Vuitton clay. I don't know why these pieces are difficult to get right now. They shouldn't be. But I have the clay in all three of the traditional Vuitton prints, the monogram, the Damier Ben, the Damier Azur. I don't have it in the Damier Graphite. I'm not sure if I want to get it or not. I'm on the fence about that. If they ever come out with one that's monogram eclipse, that black and gray monogram, that I want. Don't know why they haven't released that yet. And the denim. This is a very difficult to find piece. I love it. It's soft. It's also something that if you do find it and it's in good condition, it tends to be really expensive on the pre-loved market. So I love that. That's my most prized clay for sure. And clay means key pouch, and they have these little clips that are there to hold your keys. I don't use them for keys because I don't want to wear the gold plating off, or the gold toned plating off. So I tend to use these as bag charms. So I'll hang this, I'll put cards in it, especially at the airport when we used to be able to go to the airport. I would clip this on my Neverfull. Actually, I'd clip this one on my Neverfull because this is the one that would match it. And I'd have my ID in there, so it was really easy to get out for security. Let me show you real quick. For those who are new to Louis Vuitton and don't know how to open these clips, you take this side, you pull it up, and then it comes out. There's a little spring in there. So up and back down. It's impossible to figure that out unless someone shows you. Nearly impossible. I also have the mini pochette in monogram. I would also like to get this in damier azur. I have the toiletry 15, and I keep thinking about getting the 19. I don't know, I'm on the fence about it. Great piece. And I have three pochette accessoires. I have this limited edition Stephen Sprouse graffiti in the green. It's my favorite one. I would really like to find the Speedy in great shape in this print at a decent price. And that was the old model pochette. This is the new model pochette in monogram. I have videos comparing the two. I'll link that video below. And I have the new model pochette in damier azur. I also have two Neverfull pochettes. This is from the MM size Neverfull. If you get the MM or the GM Neverfull, it comes with this size pouch. If you get the PM, it'll come with a smaller pouch. This one's in damier ebène. This one is in épi noir, which is black. And my last pouch is the cosmetic pouch in the PM size. I would like to get the GM in the plain monogram. And this one is in the limited edition palm dots print. And there's another colorway with, I think it's pink palm leaves and red dots. I have one wallet from Louis Vuitton. That's the Sarah full-size wallet. And I probably have some things in here, but you open this up, it has like 16 card slots in the zippered compartment, these two bigger compartments, card slots up front, and a big slip pocket in the back. If you like big wallets, this is the one I would recommend. I have downsized to smaller wallets and card holders, so I haven't used this in a long time, but I don't want to get rid of it. I want to have a full-size wallet in my collection, because someday I may need it again. I also have these two pieces. These are the inserts from the Felici pochette. I don't have the Felici, just the inserts. And these are in the Empreinte Noir. So there's the zipped pouch, flat, very pretty. Only Empreinte pieces I have. I would like to get more Empreinte. I would really like a bag in Empreinte, but I don't know which bag. Do you have any suggestions? Not the Artsy, something else. Probably not the Pochette Matisse either. And then this is the other one. I use this a lot in bags that are small where I need something more compact and that have a flat pocket because this slips right down in there. It's perfect. It has 8 card slots and then it has the slip pocket up here for bills or receipts or whatever. It's a very handy piece. Not the prettiest piece, but very practical. Oh, and Becca, my sales associate at Louis Vuitton, told me that she has people coming in asking if they can buy these just on their own without the Felici bag. The answer is no. You cannot just go in and buy these from Louis Vuitton. You could only buy these separately if you buy them on the pre-loved market, which is what I did. The prices really vary on them. I got these for $200 each. And I would say that's a good price for them, even though they should not cost that much. I also have this card holder from Louis Vuitton in monogram and reverse monogram. This is the only card holder I had from them. I wanted a piece in reverse monogram, that's why I got this. But I have to say, I really don't like this card holder very much, especially compared to every other card holder I have. This is my least favorite. It just doesn't hold much. The canvas isn't very pliable. It's not that functional. It's pretty to look at. It look good in pictures, I guess, but I don't find it very functional. I also have two sunglass holders. These are the MM size. There's a smaller one in the PM size that I would like to get in monogram. This one obviously is in monogram, and this one is in damier azur. These are very difficult pieces to find, especially the azur. The azur is almost impossible to find. If you ever find this, it's going to be very expensive, most likely. These are going to be a little expensive too, but they're a little easier to find. They pop up on Fashion File pretty regularly. One thing to know about these, if you're going to get one, is this little snap, the part here where it folds up and down, the glazing tends to peel off. So try to find one that doesn't have that issue. I've used these a lot and I've never had that issue. So I got them from a good batch, I guess. I'm lucky, but I know a lot of people have had that issue. And I love these. I highly recommend them. They're like smushy. They're a little padded inside. They have a microfiber inside. Just such a pretty little piece. Oh, and I forgot to mention, I was going to say this when I showed you my clays. I have the round coin purse with the cerises, the cherries. The inside of this is red. The coin purses that they make nowadays with the animation, which they release at Christmas time or a couple months before Christmas, they don't have the clip anymore, which really stinks. And the thing about this one that stinks is the cherries hang sideways. Why don't they think of that when they're designing these pieces? It's not that hard. But it's a very cute limited edition piece. Glad to have it in my collection. Would not mind also having the pochette accessoire with the cherries. Now it's time for some of the most fun pieces, the luggage tags and bag charms. I use the luggage tags as bag charms. I'll show you the more plain ones first, and then we'll go up to the more fun limited edition pieces. This is the first one I ever got. You cannot walk into, well, generally speaking, you cannot walk into Louis Vuitton and buy a luggage tag. Their policy is that you can only get a luggage tag if you buy a bag that comes with a luggage tag. However, when I purchased my first bag from Louis Vuitton, like from the boutique, which was my Neverfull MM in Damier Ben, I asked about a luggage tag and they let me purchase one. And for those who don't know, the Louis Vuitton price on the luggage tag, there are two sizes. This is the small one. Here's the large one. They're both under $100. Now, I don't know the current price, but I think it's like $65 and $85. It's going to be somewhere around there, maybe a little more, but they're under $100. So when you see luggage tags, plain Vachetta ones, and especially ones that are not in great condition, and you see them way over $100, don't do that. I mean, if it's a limited edition piece or has a special stamp or something, like some of the ones I'll show you, that's different. But if it's a plain Vachetta tag or a plain Aben tag, beware. Okay, so I got the Aben tab. They hot stamped it for me with my initials. Then I have this small green tag. Vert is green. And they stamped that with an A for me. This was gifted to me by Doc Luxury on YouTube. And I have this black luggage tag. I don't have any stamps on this. I'm sort of holding out for if there's a special stamp that comes up that I can get. I have a tag ready to go for it. Purchased, if I remember correctly, I purchased this one pre-loved. I don't think anybody gave it to me. I didn't buy it from Louis Vuitton, so it'd have to be pre-loved. This is a small luggage tag in Vachetta. This was gifted to me Lily LV, and I had it stamped by Louis Vuitton with the A. And then I have this plain Vachetta luggage tag, no stamping. This was gifted to me by Winnie B. LV with the purpose of painting it. She gave me one and Yota Style one because we both paint. I haven't had a second to think about what I'll put on it, but I will do something with that at some point. Now I have three Vachetta luggage tags with special stamps on them. Two are New York stamps. So on this side, it's the regular thing, and then the stamp is on the back. It's the Statue of Liberty, and I purchased that, I think I got it from eBay? I don't remember. Or maybe I got it from Fashion File or The RealReal. By the way, all these resellers where I buy things and I get deals on most things. Say that. I have all of them linked below, so make sure you check that out if you're looking for anything. Or if you're not looking for anything, you can go browse like I do and find things you never knew you needed. I also have this tag with the New York Apple stamp. I love that. That's my favorite of the two New York stamps. And then this tag I found on Tradesy. And by the way, all of the location stamps, like the New York stamp, this stamp, you can only get those stamps at that location. Like the New York stamps, you can only get in New York. And I don't think every store had every New York stamp, because there were several more. I think each store had a different stamp. So you'd have to go to each store to get all of them. This one is Firenze. That's in Italy. It's Florence, Italy. And I had never seen this before. It popped up on Tradesy. I snatched it up because it was, even though it was more than I wanted to pay for it, it was a lot cheaper than a trip to Florence, Italy, to get it done myself. And then my last two luggage tags are limited edition pieces. They're hard to find. They're expensive when you do find them. This is my newest one. This is from the men's collection. Actually, they're both from the men's collection. This is the Chapman Brothers luggage tag with the rhinoceros. And it has the monogram on the back. If you've noticed any of these clips, I've added the clips. If you want to buy clips, I'll have Dress Up Your Purse linked below with a discount code. And she sells these clips as well as all kinds of other wonderful things. The one thing, maybe you guys can help me solve this. You see how this luggage tag, there's this little clip that holds it together right there. It holds the strap together. This doesn't have that. It just sticks out, and I really want it to be, I don't know what I can use to wrap around there that won't damage or indent the leather. So if y'all have any ideas, let me know, please. Also notice how big this luggage tag is compared to the regular, this is the large luggage tag. This one's much bigger. And then this one, most prized luggage tag. I mean, this one is like impossible to find and very, very expensive if you find it. Somehow I found it. I don't even remember where and how much I paid. I'd have to go through all my receipts to find that. Also from the men's line. And this is the same size as the regular size large luggage tag. It's the turquoise luggage tag. Turquoise monogram. Is that not spectacular? I mean, and I forget who was the designer on this. Was it Virgil Abloh? Somebody let me know. Correct me. And now for the bag charms. These are all fun. I have 6 total at the moment. I have my eye on a few others. 2 of them are all metal, and the other 4 are canvas with limited edition designs printed on them. So the first and the bag charm that I recommend for anyone who has a Louis Vuitton handbag, likes bag charms, and wants to add a little sparkle. This is worth the money, even though expensive. It's like $300 for a stupid bag charm. If you're only going to get one bag charm, get this one. This is the facet bag charm in the gold. There's also a silver one that's part of the men's line, quite a bit larger than this one. This is a great size. It's beautiful. This is one of the few pieces I recommend buying new from Louis Vuitton, not getting pre-loved, just because it is metal, and on the pre-loved market, you're gonna get pieces that are scratched where the gold has worn off. Just buy this one new. I made that mistake. I bought it pre-loved, saved $50. All I saw when I looked at it were all the flaws, so I eventually sold that and bought it brand new. So don't make my mistake. Learn from my mistakes. Just buy it new in the first place. The other metal one is on the bag behind me, so let me grab that. This is the Fleur de Monogram bag charm on my Trevi PM. I bought it specifically for this bag, although I can also wear it on my Terrain and my Speedies and Neverfulls, but I love it on this bag. This one I did buy pre-loved because I wasn't willing to pay the brand new price for it because it was stupid expensive. $500 or $600 for a bag charm. I ended up paying $370 or $380 something for it. It's in great shape. It doesn't have scratches in the wear. One thing about buying pre-loved, especially if you have specific items you're looking for and you're looking for the right condition and price, you have to have patience. I waited to find this for years. I don't know how many years, 2 or 3 years. Before I found the right one, right condition, right price. Be prepared. If you're looking for something, it doesn't just come up overnight, usually. Sometimes it does, though. Fleur de Monogram. Love this. I noticed when I was editing my Louis Vuitton handbag video that at the end of presenting different pieces, I would say, I love this on just about everything. And that's because I do. I have the collection I have amassed over these years. I'm deliberate about it. I buy things that I will either really use, like my planners, or that I really love, like the limited edition pieces, or that I just think is really beautiful, like that handbag, and especially with the charm on it. So I really do love all of my pieces, and if I don't, then I sell it, but that's rare because I do my research first and I know what I like. 4 bag charms left, all limited edition pieces. This is the Kusama, I forget what the print is called, because there's like pumpkin dots and something else. Bobster92 will know, and he will leave it in the comment section for me, I'm sure. But this is the white one. It also comes in some other colors. You can see it's over the monogram print, and on the back, it's white, and it has Kusama's signature. And I purchased all of these pre-loved except this one. This I got brand new in the store. It's the Christmas Animation 2017 with the penguins. And it has this light blue on the back. That one I only wear in December, but I love penguins like so many other people. Had to have it. One of the prized pieces of my Louis Vuitton collection is my Turquoise V bag charm over monogram. The back is turquoise. I love this. Another piece that took years and years to find for the right price and the right condition. And the last piece, another very difficult one to find. I had the chance to buy this in the store and didn't, and then regretted it because it's a piece that is very hard to find, and when you find it, it is crazy expensive. But somehow I found this one on Fashion File, excellent condition and a great price. It is the Nightbird bag charm. It has the owl on epi leather with this gold V that's 3D. Can you see it sticking out there? And then on the back, it's black. Beautiful piece. I keep this one on my Suhali locket in bronze, and it just works really well with that bag. It would also look great on my black Neverfull in Nappy. Well, I think that's everything. I hope I got it all. I knew that was going to be another long video, but I feel like I did pretty well about not talking for 5 minutes about each piece. Remember to check the description box for the websites where I have found the best bargains on these things, and also for more videos on some of these pieces that you might be interested in learning more about. And remember the two questions I asked earlier. One, what would you put on my luxury wish list? And two, what is your favorite Louis Vuitton small good? Let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. Remember to stay tuned throughout this month for more collection videos. I have my contemporary pieces like Coach Rebecca Minkoff, Kurt Geiger, I don't know what else, Tory Burch. I have that coming up, and I have my Metallics collection coming up. Next Saturday will be all of my other luxury items that are not Louis Vuitton. Hermes, Chanel, Gucci, Givenchy, YSL. So stay tuned for all that. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. I hope you and your loved ones are doing well. I hope to see you back here next time, and I hope you have a fabulous day. Bye.